times an hour you check your phone, maybe 5 times a dozen, maybe more. And how do all these macro interruptions change your day? Do they make you less productive? Do they affect your daily well-being? How might your life will look if you were able to control these distractions? Or to literally silence your phone? And dedicate yourself specific tasks in front of you. This is a very new reality we're facing as human beings, and it's completely changing us. My topic is phone addiction. Today I would like to inform you guys that in smartphones can keep you from learning and doing smart things. I'm sure you guys can relate to this topic, because we all have smartphones. I have done a lot of research on phone addiction and how we can avoid it. Today I would like to talk about what is smartphone addiction, the cause and effect of smartphone addiction, and some ways that we can. Let's talk about what is smartphone addiction. Smartphone addiction is known as nomophobia. Nomophobia is fear of being without smartphones. Having a smartphone, tablet, or computers can be a huge productive tool. But when you are using social media, spending more time on social media than interacting with real life people, that can be a huge problem. Fun fact, one in three cell phone owners would rather give up sex than their phones. According to addicted.com, 40% of the population is addicted to their smartphones. So now that we talked about what is smartphone addiction, let's talk about the cause and effect of smartphone addiction. The cause of smartphone addiction is usually using too much in a smartphone and not knowing when to stop. Some of the effects is back pain, neck problems, and your eyes can get like red. Teens tend to affect social media than adults, because adults can take negative comments. Studies have shown spending more time on social media is bad for your focus and mental health. For example, last 2 months, my brother's birthday. He was turning 15, so I bought him iPhone X because he broke his last one. So this kid was so excited that he didn't went outside for a week and a half. And my mom started to notice that he don't get enough sleep and his eyes are getting red day by day. So she told my dad. And my dad, to this day, didn't manage his hours of using his phone. So far, I have covered what cause and effect of phone addiction. So now let's talk about some ways that we can improve in cell phone addiction. One way that you can limit your time is you can outsmart your smartphone by using screen time. Screen time is an app that tells you the amount of time that you use on your apps. The second way you can improve on this addiction is you can turn off your notification or not have your phone when you go into bed. One in four people will not put their phone on silent when going to bed. In conclusion, today I have informed you that what is smartphone addiction, what is the cause and effect, and some ways that you can improve smartphone addiction. We all have cell phones, but we overuse them, and it can be it can be a problem sometimes for your health and for the people that you love. So let's outsmart the smartphone by giving less attention and using our mind more often.
Thank you.